The cosmos is all that is, or ever was, or ever will be. Come with me.
A generation ago, the astronomer Carl Sagan stood here and launched hundreds of millions of us on a great adventure. The exploration of the universe revealed by science. It's time to get going again.
We're about to begin a journey that will take us from the infinitesimal to the infinite, from the dawn of time to the distant future. We'll explore galaxies and suns and worlds, surf the gravity waves of space-time, encounter beings that live in fire and ice, explore the planets of stars that never die, discover atoms as massive as suns and universes smaller than atoms. Cosmos is also a story about us. It's the saga of how wandering bands of hunters and gatherers found their way to the stars. One adventure with many heroes.
To make this journey, we'll need imagination. But imagination alone is not enough, because the reality of nature is far more wondrous than anything we can imagine. This adventure is made possible by generations of searchers strictly adhering to a simple set of rules. Test ideas by experiment and observation. Build on those ideas that pass the test. Reject the ones that fail. Follow the evidence wherever it leads, and question everything. Accept these terms, and the cosmos is yours. Now, come with me. Of the imagination, free from the shackles of space and time, we can go anywhere. Do you want to see where we are in space? Just look out the front window. In the dimension of time, the past lies beneath us. Here's what Earth looked like 250 million years ago. If you want to see the future, look up. And this is how it could appear 250 million years from now. If we're going to be venturing out into the farthest reaches of the cosmos, we need to know our cosmic address. And this is the first line of that address. We're leaving the Earth, the only home we've ever known, for the farthest reaches of the cosmos. Our nearest neighbor, the Moon, has no sky, no ocean, no life, just the scars of cosmic impacts. Our star powers the wind and the waves and all the life on the surface of our world. The sun holds all the worlds of the solar system in its gravitational embrace, starting with Mercury. To
cloud-covered Venus, where a runaway greenhouse effect has turned it into a kind of hell. Mars, a world with as much land as Earth itself. A belt of rocky asteroids circles the sun between the orbits of Mars and Jupiter. With its four giant moons and dozens of smaller ones, Jupiter is like its own little solar system. It has more mass than all the other planets combined. Jupiter's Great Red Spot. A hurricane three times the size of our whole planet that's been raging for centuries. The crown jewel of our solar system, Saturn, ringed by freeways of countless orbiting and slowly tumbling snowballs. Every snowball, a little moon. Uranus and Neptune, the outermost planets, unknown to the ancients and only discovered after the invention of the telescope. Beyond the outermost planet, there's a swarm of tens of thousands of frozen worlds. Pluto is one of them. Of all our spacecraft, this is the one that's traveled farthest from home. Voyager 1. She bears a message to a billion years from now. Something of who we were, how we felt, and the music we made. The deeper waters of this vast cosmic ocean and their numberless worlds lie ahead.